Hello students, today we are going to learn about ultrasound. This topic is from electrotherapy. Ultrasound is high frequency modality. If you look this word, you have idea that ultrasound is made up of two words, ultra plus sound. So before start with ultrasound, we must know what is sound waves. First, what is sound waves? Sound waves are a periodic mechanical disturbance in an elastic material. It can be occur in any material like air, solid or liquid. There is a series of mechanical compression and refraction in a direction of a travel of the wave. So the sound waves are the longitudinal wave energy. Sound waves frequency lies between 20 to 20,000 hertz. This sound we can hear. Human being can hear the sound between 20 to 20,000 hertz, or you can say this is the audible sound. The sound waves which have frequency beyond the 20,000 hertz or 20 kilohertz, they are the ultrasound waves, and the frequency less than 20 hertz are the infrasound waves. In therapeutic purpose, we are using ultrasound waves which have frequency between 0.5 to 5 megahertz, and in physiotherapy field we are using 1 or 3 megahertz frequency of ultrasound therapy. So in this figure you can see the periodic compression and refraction of the molecules which produces the sound waves. You can see the mechanical disturbance which travel longitudinally through the compression and refraction of the molecules of the material. So the sound wave or sound energy can travel in any material or any medium, but it can not travel or not cross the vacuum. The sound wave energy is a longitudinal waveform. The sound wave has particular wavelength, particular frequency and velocity. Therapeutically, the frequency of ultrasound waves which we are using in clinic is 1 or 3 megahertz, but the velocity of ultrasound in a different material is depends on the physical nature of that particular medium. As we know, the sonic energy or ultrasound cannot pass without any medium. They cannot cross vacuum, so they require some medium to pass. So the sound wave will pass more rapidly through the material which the molecules are close together. So they are pass very fast in solid and liquid compared to gas. Now if we talk about other uses of ultrasound, waves can be used in many industries for the cleaning and mixing procedure, and it can be also used to detect the cracks in the product. And this ultrasound energy is also used for in medical field. As we know, ultrasound or ultrasonography is used as a diagnostic tool for many pathology, and ultrasound energy is also used in a surgical procedure, mainly for the dental surgeries. Now, production of therapeutic ultrasound. The therapeutic ultrasound is produced by reverse piezoelectric effect. So, to understand the reverse piezoelectric effect, we must understand what is piezoelectric effect. If you see this word piezoelectric effect, this is a combination of two words, piezo plus electric. So what is meaning of piezo? Piezo means mechanical pressure or stress, and electric means production of electromagnetic force. So piezoelectric effect means when some particular substance is subjected to mechanical stress, they produces the electromagnetic force. This particular substance are known as piezoelectric substance. When they are under effect of mechanical pressure, they produces electric force. So example of this piezoelectric substance are quartz, which we get from nature, and the other examples which produces this effect are barium titanate and lead zirconate titanate, which we produces artificially for the production of ultrasound energy. So the therapeutic ultrasound is produced by the reverse piezoelectric effect. So here this particular substance, or the quartz crystal or a piezoelectric substance, are subjected to different potential differences, and they are under the effect of electric or potential differences, and ultimately they produce is the mechanical disturbance. And so you can produce therapeutic ultrasound through reverse piezoelectric effect. So when these crystals like quartz crystals or barium titanate or lead zirconate titanate crystals are subjected to different potential differences, they deform and produces the mechanical disturbance and produces the sound waves. So, in order to apply the electrical charges, the metal electrode must be fixed to the crystal. If a suitable metal plate is fixed to one surface of the crystal while the opposite surface is in air, then almost all the vibrational energy is transmitted from the crystal to the plate and hence to any solid or liquid to which it is applied. So here is the figure of apparatus of the ultrasound circuit. Ultrasound circuit consists sine wave generator, which produces high frequency. When we switch on the power supply, the potential difference from the generator creates, and from the metal and plate it transfer to the crystal. Crystal, as we know, it is quartz crystal or barium titanate crystal, which is piezoelectric substance. when it under the potential difference effect, it converts electric energy into the mechanical energy, and we get a sound waves. So ultrasound head is also known as transducer head or crystal. So what is transducer? The transducer is a substance which converts one energy form into another form of energy. Here the gating circuit, you can see the gating circuit in the figure, which is very important part of ultrasound machine. This circuit can be on and off according the which mode of ultrasound we want to use. If we want to use continuous mode of ultrasound, then this circuit is continuously on, and if we want to use pulsed mode, then this circuit will automatically switch off and switch on accordingly which pulse ratio we want to select. Here you can see the ultrasound machine. There is a different size of head of ultrasounds we can see in the figure. The head of ultrasound is also known as transducer head, which converts one energy form into the another energy form. Now another terminology which we must know is power. What is power? The power is amount of sonic energy per unit time, and the intensity is a power per unit area of the ultrasound head. So whenever we are mentioning the intensity of ultrasound or dosage, we must write the unit watt per centimeter square. So as we understand the production of ultrasound, now some other terminology which are important to learn. Sound wave, as we know, produces from the head of the ultrasound. So these sound waves which are produced are some are cancelled out, others are reinforced, so that the net result, there is a very irregular pattern of sonic waves in the region close to the transducer head, which is called near field or a Fresnel zone. Practically we are concerned with the near field, and as the distance from the transducer head increases, the pattern of sonic waves become uniform. To overcome this irregularity of the near field, we should move the treatment head or ultrasound head throughout the treatment. And the near field is known as Fresnel zone, and the far field is known as Fraunhofer zone. Now here is a partial average intensity. You must know the word partial. It is related with the place or space. So here the partial average intensity, which is average intensity of ultrasound output over the area of transducer head. So what the amount of energy, average energy which we get from the transducer head, it is the intensity of that energy, and what is a special peak intensity? The peak intensity of the ultrasound output over the area of transducer head. So you can see very easily from the figure the spatial peak intensity and spatial average intensity. So you can see that the intensity is usually great in the center of the beam and the lowest at the edges of the beam. Now, what is beam non-uniformity ratio? The ratio between peak intensity and average intensity in the beam. The lower the B and R, the more uniform the beam. Suppose B and R is 5:1, when the spatial average intensity is 1 watt per centimeter square and spatial peak intensity would be 5 watt per centimeter square. So if this ratio is more, you can say the more ultrasonic beam you get. As we know, the frequency here for the physiotherapy purpose, we are using mainly 3 megahertz and 1 megahertz ultrasound waves. So we know what is the frequency, the number of compression and refraction cycle per unit of time is known as frequency. This is usually expressed in a cycle per second, or the unit of frequency is hertz. Increasing the frequency of ultrasound causes a decrease in its depth of penetration and concentration of ultrasound energy in the superficial tissue. So you can say, if I want to treat a deeper structure, then I have to take option of 1 megahertz, and if I want to treat superficial structures, then I have to opt 3 megahertz option of ultrasound energy. Now, effective radiating area, which is the ERA, the area of transducer from which the ultrasound energy radiates. As we know, the crystal does not vibrate uniformly, so the ERA is always smaller than the area of the treatment head. So here we are completed with the part 1 of this lecture series. So let us quickly summarize this lecture. In first, we have know about what is sonic waves, then we learn about ultrasonic waves, then how ultrasound is produced, then we have know about apparatus of ultrasonic modality, then different terminology which are related with the ultrasound therapy. In that, we have learned about near field, which we are always used in treatment, so to overcome the irregularity of the near field, we must move the treatment head continuously. Then we understand about spatial intensity, then spatial peak intensity, then we learn about power, and the unit of intensity is watt per centimeter square. Then we learn about what is beam non-uniformity ratio, and at the end we know about effective radiating area. Thank you.